Did you figure it out? Hey, my name is Fresh Tortowalk. Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. You might have a little deja vu, at least 1,000 people of you guys watching me. We already tackled this using Laplace transforms, but I made a stupid-ass mistake last time, and only one person really noticed. Don't trust everything I do. Sometimes I'm making mistakes, I'm improvising all those videos, I just know the problem, and then I'm working through it on the blackboard. So most of the time, I don't even know what I'm doing right here. So feel free to tell me if I do any mistakes. Let's remake this one using Laplace transforms. So we have an upper and lower bound from minus infinity to infinity, and we are not dealing with bilateral Laplace transforms. So what we want to do at first is use the evenness, oddness of this function. So we are having an even integrand right here, so we can rewrite this integral as 2 times the integral from 0 to infinity of sine squared of x over x squared dx. So that looks nice. But we are missing something else. Well, we don't have a time-dependent factor in here. So let's define a new integral, actually. Let some I in terms of t equal to 2 times the integral from 0 to infinity of, and now we are bringing a little factor of t. T is going to be strictly positive into here, over x squared dx. And now we can work with this. So let's use the Laplace transform on I in terms of t and see what we get. So the Laplace transform of I in terms of t. Well, what is that? By definition, the Laplace transform is just the improper integral from 0 to infinity of I in terms of t e to the minus st dt. So far, so good. And now let's plug in the definition for our I in terms of t. Okay, we have a factor of 2, we can bring it to the front. So we have 2 times the integral from 0 to infinity, but when t goes from 0 to infinity, of the integral from 0 to infinity, this is in terms of x right here, of sine squared t times x over x squared. Well, e to the minus st in terms of x is just a constant, so we can bring it to the inside, e to the minus st, and now we have dx dt. And I have fought all those mathematical bad boys once before, so without any restrictions, we are going to change the order of integration because we just can. We have one defined, and now let's do this. So we have 2 times the integral, and now from from x going to 0 to infinity of, okay, I'm bringing this factor of 1 over x squared to the front. So we have 1 over x squared. And now we have the integral from 0 to infinity. This is in terms of t now, don't forget that, of sine squared t times x times e to the minus st dt and then dx. So we have changed the order of integration using Papa Fubini. And you might notice something. This right here is just the Laplace transform of sine squared t times x. And that's nice because we have derived this before. Link to it will be in the description. Okay, so let's plug this in. Now we have 2 times the integral from 0 to infinity of 1 over x squared. And now let's do it right. The Laplace transform of sine squared of t times x is just, okay, so we have 2 times x squared over a factor of s. That's what I forgot last time. S squared plus 4 x squared dx. And you might notice something nice. This and that we cancel out. And well, we can bring this 2 to the front to make a 4 out of it. And there's a factor of 1 over s. We can also bring it to the outside. So what we end up with now is just 4 over s times the integral from 0 to infinity of, this right here is going to be kind of the inverse tangent. So let's manipulate it a little bit, because we want to isolate this x right here, this x squared. So let's factor out a 4. So we have 1 over 4 right here. And what else do we get? So we have 1 over, and now we have this x squared term. That's what we wanted to get. And also we have plus s squared over 4. We can rewrite this a little bit as s over 2, but the whole thing squared. And then dx. This and that will cancel out, and we end up with this right here, which is just the inverse tangent. So In conclusion, we now know that the Laplace transform of I in terms of t is nothing else than, okay, we have this 1 over s factor. And also we have, well, let's take the reciprocal of this right here, this little term. That's the definition, link in the description. So we have 2 over s times the inverse tangent of, and we have x over s over 2 from 0 to infinity. Well, the inverse tangent of 0 is just 0, so that's just 0. And also, if we let the inverse tangent approach infinity, so the argument, we would end up with pi over 2. So that's quite nice. So our final answer is 1 over s squared times 2 times pi over 2. Doesn't that we cancel out? So we have pi over s squared. But don't forget, we are dealing with the Laplace transform of I in terms of t. We want to go back to our original I in terms of t. So now let's use the inverse Laplace transform on the Laplace transform of I in terms of t, which is just pi over s squared. So now, the inverse Laplace transform of pi over s squared. Well, pi is just a constant in terms of the inverse Laplace transform, so let's bring it to the outside. And also, 1 over s squared, the inverse Laplace transform is just t. So that's nice. And well, now we have the right solution. Less time something wrong did imply something right. That's something that holds in mathematics, but this time we are doing everything right. And don't forget, this is just the solution to I in terms of t. So in order for us to get a solution to our original integral, for example I, well, we just need t to be equal to 1. So that also means that our I is just I in terms of t equals to 1. Let's define our I. This is our I. And well, this is just pi. And then we are done. So that's the real solution to our problem. And I thank you guys for watching. If you did enjoy this video, please like and subscribe and recommend me if you like. If you want to support me a bit more, take a look into the description. There will be a link to my Patreon. I'm doing all this stuff for free, so I would highly appreciate some support from you guys, because YouTube isn't hurrying the fuck up. It's so annoying. They have delayed everything till end of June. They are just delaying this reviewing process over and over again, and yeah, this channel isn't just getting monetized. It's just fucking ridiculous. Hurry the fuck up, YouTube. Please. Never mind. I like to entertain you guys, and I hope you enjoyed this video. And up until the next video, have flamble day. See ya. Nun, angesichts der Tatsache, dass sich drei meiner 12 unveröffentlichten Drehbücher mit Lykantropen im weiteren Sinne befassen, weiß ich ganz sicher.
Jetzt auf! Verdammte Scheiße!